Turn to John chapter 10. It is good to be saved. On the Lord's side, headed toward heaven. Need your prayers. Seem like my sinuses are running down my throat faster than I can swallow right now, but I need your prayers this morning. John chapter 10, and start reading at verse 7. And Jesus said unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that came before me were thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man may enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and destroy. Amen. Listen to what Jesus says next. But I am come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. And the good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. Father, I thank you, Lord Jesus, for your mercy and for your grace. I thank you, Lord, for the hope that we have in you. And I pray for a few minutes, Lord, this morning, hide your servant behind the very cross of Calvary, Lord. I know, Lord Jesus, you know exactly what we need in this building this morning. Send the showers of blessings among us, we pray, in Jesus' holy name, and amen, and amen. You may be seated. While you're being seated, I actually want to read one more verse out of Corinthians. He says, and God is able, this is 2 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 8, if you want to mark it down and read it later, there in your bulletin. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye always, having all sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. Now, reading those two verses, I want to preach on this thought, if it be the will of God, for just a little while. Amen. I want to preach, I'm a rich man. Amen. I realize today that if Rhonda would pull up our bank account down at Farmers Bank and you'd look at our checking account and our savings account, that you'd probably laugh me out of town. But let me give you the definition today. I mentioned earlier, and I've said it before, you folks know I love definitions of what things mean anymore. Let me give you the definition of what that word abundantly means. Abundantly means existing or occurring in large amounts. It means marked by great plenty. It means amply supplied. The word sufficiently means in this, it means having all things applied or that's needed today. When I think we think about riches today, we think about fellows like Donald Trump and some of the other people like that. I realized before he was ever president, he was recognized as a rich man, and the Rockefellers and all the different people around this world that have great wealth that they've stored up here in this life today. But I want you to understand something about what they have. The difference between what I have and what they have. Amen. What they have, thief can destruct. The thief can come in and steal. But what I have is a child of God today. Amen. Listen, none thief can't touch it. Nobody give it to me except God, and nobody can take it away. Amen. Listen, let me give you a definition of what the word rich means real fast as I get in this. Having abundant possessions, well supplied or renowned. It means, listen to this, to rich means to be entertaining. I kind of laughed at that one. Then I laughed at the next one. To rich means to be laughable. Means to be meaningful. It means to be significant. Can I tell you today, amen, I don't want to be a boring child of God. Amen. Let alone be a boring preacher. I want to be laughable. I want to be full of joy. I want my life, when people look at me, amen, that a smile comes to their face, not because maybe how I look. I realize sometimes maybe I look funny, whatever, how I'm dressed, amen, with some of the colors of jackets and stuff that I wear sometimes, amen. But I want you to understand today, amen, number one, I've got joy that's unspeakable and full of glory, and that makes me rich. You see, this world is looking for joy. They're looking for something today to bring them happiness in this life. But they don't have it. But can I tell you, I am rich beyond measure because I've got that joy that Christ gave today. I said, I've come that you might have joy, that your joy might be unspeakable, full of glory, that your joy might remain, that your joy might be fruitful today. I want you to understand, I want my life to be meaningful. Amen. Listen, I realize today, amen, I probably will never make a great mark on society as far as having my name put somewhere. Amen. Listen, on some big building or some highway. Oh, but listen, I want you to know today, when it comes to the things of God, I want my life to count. And I can tell you this, amen, I shared this with you, some of you already, 25 years ago today, I stood for the first time to preach God's everlasting word. And can I tell you today, amen, listen, I'm not telling you I've always did everything I should, but I can tell you today, I can look back and I can tell you people's lives that God has used this boy to change their life. Amen. If their life has been changed by what God has used me, that tells me today my life has meaning and it has purpose today. Significant. Amen. I know today that in the lives of these two girls sitting right here, my life is significant. Amen. I'm the husband, I'm the father. Amen. But not only that, as I stand in front of this congregation this morning, I know that my life is significant. And that God has placed me as the under shepherd under him. Amen. To be the shepherd over this flock. I want you to know it's an honor and a privilege for me. I don't understand people that don't love to pastor. Amen. Listen, God called me for that purpose. Amen. I like going out and preaching other places. Amen. But there's nothing more rewarding. Amen. Listen, than seeing someone. Brother Johnny mentioned yesterday, it was 2 years ago. Amen. We all can sit here in this house. Amen. And see where God's brought Brother Johnny, how he has matured in Christ. Not only him. Amen. Listen, I'll be honest. Amen. There was a time I never in my life thought, amen, that Joe Chokolman would be sitting on the front pew of a church, amen, enjoying himself. I never thought that Joe Chokolman, amen, would lift his hands, amen, and say, I love my church. But thank God, God has used us to make a difference. Brother, I don't know about you, but I'm feeling pretty rich this morning. Glory to God. Amen. If we count our things of the things that we don't have, amen, we're going to spend our life miserable today. Our life is not counted or not measured by the things that we don't have. Amen. Listen, I thought of some of the things that God has blessed me with. And number one, that little lady that sits right there that's holding that phone today, amen, for 27 years. Amen. She's laid beside me every night. When I've been troubled, she says, what's wrong? She prays with me. She talks with me. She shares a burden with me. Brother, that makes me rich today, that I have a helpmeet. Amen. Listen, somebody said, behind every good man is a good woman. Brother, man stands beside me when I come. Listen, it's not a matter. Amen. Listen, when I get ready to go preach, brother, she's ready to go as well. Every man can't say that. I'm rich today. I'm rich. I thought of all the miles that we've traveled. I told you last night we traveled 295 miles from our house to the time we left and went to church and come back to that church, back to our house, 295 miles. Got home at 1:15 this morning. Amen. Listen, she didn't feel like getting out of bed this morning, but I want you to know she did. She pushed. I'm telling you, the hour of sleep she's lost. Amen. To stand behind her, stand beside her man and support him. I'm telling you, brother, that means the world to this little boy. Amen. And it ought to mean something to you today. I've got peace. Another thing that the world is looking for. They don't have any peace. They're troubled on every side. But I want you to know today, amen, listen again, when I lay my head on my pillow at night, I don't have any trouble going to sleep the majority of the time. When I do, it's because I'm troubled more. Listen, not for what I don't have. Amen, I'm troubled for somebody on what they're going through, Brother Johnny. Amen, maybe somebody that's lost. Maybe somebody that's sick and afflicted. And I lay and I pray for them. I've got more love, amen, than I can measure today. I've got people in this building, amen, that I knew that if I called you at 3 o'clock in the morning and said I need you, you'd get your shoes and your shirt and your pants, and you'd grab your wallet and your keys, and you'd come to my rescue. Amen, you'd be there, brother. I'm telling you today, I'm a rich man. Amen, I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain. Amen, covered by His blood. Here's something that God has given me in the last 25 years. Amen. God has given me temperance. You know what temperance is? Temperance is being able to handle pressure. Amen. I'm telling you today, I had a fellow tell me one time, and I still disagree with him sometimes. He said, your wisdom is well beyond your years. And I looked at him and I said, I thank you, amen, but I really don't agree with you today. But I want you to realize today that God has made me what I am. It's God that in the hour, amen, listen, when I should be heartbroken, when I should be down and out, that has given me the strength to stand. It's God that helps me to come into a room of a family that's brokenhearted, to stand at the end of a coffin as they come by and say, listen, and they give that last kiss, that last glance before that body's buried. It's God that's given me the ability to stand there with that family and say, weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. It's God that has given me the temperance when somebody causes trouble in the church, that I can look at them and say, either make it right or hit the road, Jack. It's God today that makes us this way. Amen. I'm a rich man. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Am I hard-headed? I absolutely, I'm hard-headed. Oh, I got a lot of more amens than that on that. Especially from that seat right there. I've already mentioned this one, it's family. Not only family here, but again, we traveled 295 miles last night with family. Some of them folks I grew up with, some I just knew. But I had brothers that go to other churches that I've been affiliated with down there that came to that church. Amen. We stopped, brother, yesterday with Brother Jackie Grimmett's birthday. I'm telling you, one of my best friends in this world. Amen. Listen, I love him. Amen. As well as I would my own brother. Amen. Yesterday, here's his birthday. I always call him. He said, it amazes me that you never forget. I'm telling you, brother, you don't forget your family's birthday. Amen. And I realize sometimes I fail on that as a pastor here, maybe to do some of those things. But I'm telling you, he means something to me. And why is it? Because he's the one that when I said that God has called me to preach, he said, next Thursday night, son, you'll be hitting the floor. I want you to know today, it's him that encouraged me. It's him that taught me. And that means something. Yesterday we stopped by his house. We went in and sang happy birthday to him. He said, you fellas going to make me cry. Amen. I met him after Wendy's. That's why I got home so late. Amen. I had to wait on him. I wanted to see him. Listen, that's family. My family's not just, amen, my flesh and blood. Amen. I've got brothers and sisters around this world. Hey, listen, that I've never met family.
face to face. Oh, listen, I met Brother David Muhammad the other night. First time I'd ever met him. A wonderful man of God, does a great work. But I want you to understand something. Amen. We're still part of the same family. I've preached from North Carolina to West Virginia and Ohio, all over the place. Hundreds of churches, thousands of messages. I'm a blessed man. I'm not telling you those stats. I can't tell you exactly what they are. I used to keep count of them. Amen. One time I asked this, well, I'm going to see, amen, how many times I do preach in a year. And because of the different revivals and stuff, I preached, it was well over 200. Amen. A several years, and it was 180, 190. I kept track of it for a while. But you know what I realized? It's not about me keeping stats. Brother, it's about God. I want to be faithful. Let God keep the record. We realize we've got to keep a calendar. Amen. To show where we've been and all these things for the government. Today, amen, but can I tell you today, amen, here's the last thing that God has given me is the memories.
Amen. Yes. Some of the people that were there last night were there the first sermon. One lady drove all the way from Hinton, West Virginia, down to Verner. 3 hours, just like what we did. Over the hills and through the woods. There ain't no easy way to get to Hinton, is it, Johnny? No easy way to get there. Coming down, she comes across Bolt Mountain. Hey, Matt, if you've ever been across Bolt Mountain, brother, it's up there in the sky, ain't it, Joe? She was there. Little sister Lisa Walls was there. I seen her coming. I was standing at the back door when I seen her coming in. She come in with her arms stretched out. My nickname for her, Lisa's only about this tall, was Sister Shorty. Amen. Her and Joyce, they come up to me every time in my first few sermons. And I just would walk down with my head low, and I thought, oh, devil, said, boy, you sure made a mess of that. Now, I'll never forget what Lisa told me one night. She said, son, she said, God's word never returns void, but it accomplishes exactly where it's at. I'm telling you, I've got memories. I remember in Sunday school one Sunday morning at Lundale, and I just want to share these with you. I was sitting on the end beside of Judy Carter, whose husband is lost. Amen. A spirit of heaviness fell on her and a burden for her husband. Amen. Listen, as I sat beside her, that same spirit fell on me, and all I could do was weep. Amen. We saw soul after soul give her life to the Lord. I've remembered, but the day he'll get up, listen, he'll just kick that leg and he'll throw that arm and holler, woo. I'm telling you, brother, remember the memories we have. You can't replace it.
I've seen. Remember Sister Arlene Taylor? Alzheimer's was taking her mind slowly. She could not tell you whether she eat breakfast, let alone what she had. But she would sit on the second pew at Rutland Free Baptist. I'd start quoting a verse of scripture, and Sister Arlene would finish it every time. Amen. I'm going to tell you, the devil would, amen, I like to jump right in there. Amen, listen, and say she keeps cutting you off. Amen, but what I keep saying was, yeah, but she knows what she's talking about. I'm telling you today, brother, amen, I can share the memories. Amen, listen, of a lot of places I've seen the order line. Oh, listen, I've heard the testimonies. I've seen lives changed. I've seen sick people healed. I remember Sister Diane Hendricks went to the doctor's care on Friday and scheduled surgery for Monday. I had a tumor under her kneecap. Amen. Couldn't hardly walk. Amen. She come into that church, sat on that altar. We anointed that knee. Brother, she walked out of the church. Amen. They went to do the surgery. Said, let us check and make sure exactly where it's at. And they walked back in and said, it's gone. I'm telling you, brother, I've seen God move. Don't you tell me just you've come way too late to tell me that God is no good, that it's a waste of time to serve him. It's a waste of time. Amen. Listen up, late at night. Amen. Listen, I'm telling you, brother, in the middle of the night, I've been studying the Word of God. Amen. Listen, and all of a sudden, His presence, amen, has just opened that book up, and it feels like I'm walking in the land of Judah. All the memories that God has given. Does this old body get tired? Absolutely. Absolutely. Don't say this braggingly. I just said Satan, thanks. One time, God allowed me to preach 28 days in a row. And I preached 30 sometimes in that 28 days. But God's good. Give me strength to keep going. Amen. Go back to that word sufficient. An ample supply. Every day when I get up, my Bible tells me, Brother Johnny, that God has loaded me with benefits every day. Every day. Amen. An endless, I'm going to tell you, and there's an endless supply there. If your life is not rich, if you feel like your life is poor and wasted, you can waste it on this world. But can I tell you today, if you put God first, if you young people would learn to sing because you get the opportunity, not because somebody makes you get up here, I'm telling you, you'd enjoy church a whole lot more. Amen. I'm telling you, if you'd learn, amen, that you got the privilege to lift up those hands and say, oh, thank you, Jesus, for everything you've blessed me with. Amen. You'd enjoy life a whole lot more. Amen. It's not, listen, brother, it's a privilege. It's not a duty for me to praise God. It is a privilege. It is an honor for me to assemble together in a heavenly place with my brothers and sisters in Christ. Now, I want to say this. Where God ain't, I don't want to be. Where there's no spirit. I've been in some churches. Amen. And all the thing they needed was a good shovel. Because you bury anything that's dead. My, my, my. I was praying yesterday morning, knowing that I was going down there, knowing some folks that I invited that were actually friends of mine that are non-Christians, praying that they would come. Thinking about all the names we have here on this altar this morning, on this prayer cloth written down, that looks like maybe through time is fading away. Amen. But God knows them all. I don't have to name them all. If I say, God, pray, I pray for these names. I'm telling you, amen. And there was a God broke my heart yesterday morning. And all I could say was, oh, God, help us to reach them. I'm saying today, church, amen, we need to get a burden and a vision on our heart. Amen, these people are never going to be saved until we get that vision and that burden on our heart for them, where those tears begin to roll down their face. And really all we can say is, oh, God, save them. Because then, let me tell you what happens when you get to that place. It's all you can pray is, oh, God, the Spirit. Oh, glory to God. The Spirit of God makes intercessions for us with groanings that cannot be uttered today. Amen. If your life is miserable, amen, you've got nobody to blame but yourself today. Amen. If you're not enjoying living, I'm telling you, brother, you've never started living unless you give your life to the Lord. I don't care how many professions you've made, how many times you've been baptized, unless you're anchored in the rock of ages today, you need to come this morning, amen, fall on this altar and say, God, I want to start this revival out. God, I want to be that spark. God, set my field on fire. God, do for me what you've done for him. And I'm telling you, brother, he'll do it today. Amen. You don't have to live like that. No. You don't have to live that way. God can change you. Oh my, he's given to you. Listen to what he said. He said, the thief cometh to kill, to steal, and destroy. But I've come that you might have life. Oh, and have it more abundantly. Yes. I'm not saying today, amen, that you have a lot of zeros in your bank account. I've got a lot of zeros. They're on the wrong side. But I thank God for everything I have. Amen. I thought as I walked across the sidewalk into the church this morning, 25 years ago, I didn't have a suit. You look at my closet, they're crammed in there right now. Amen. Amen. I'm blessed, Brother Charlie. Yeah. Preacher, why would God give you a message like this? Amen, to show you what you can have. Because again, God don't have any respect of persons. He's not going to give me. I'm not saying that He's going to call everybody to be preaching. I'm not saying, amen, He's not going to allow you to travel and sing with a group like what I do. All this, I tell you, that's another blessing, amen. I never in my life thought that I would get to do that, but I enjoy it. What I'm telling you is, you can have more than what you got now. Amen. Because you, and only you, determine how happy you are. You, and only you, determine how close to God you are. If you draw nigh to God, God will draw nigh to you. Oh, hallelujah, I feel Him close this morning. I don't know about you. Oh, I just want to wave at Him. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Lord. My prayer has always been for my children. God, keep them close to you. Now, I know that's yours. I want my children to have a real experience with God, not a fake one. Somebody that they know that they can turn to when they feel like the world has forsaken them. I'm telling you, I've never been alone. Amen. I have never been alone. David said, though all men forsake me, he said, then will the Lord. Then will the Lord take up my cause. He fights for me. I got in trouble 2 times in school, and I'll come to a close. First time, a fellow my age threatened to punch my little brother in the face to break his nose. And I was about for me and a herald from him in the bus. And I heard it. And I stood up and I pointed my finger at him and I said, you lay a hand on him and I'll break yours. But why would you share that? Because I'm telling you, that's what God does for me. The devil can't touch me. Amen. Amen. Why? I belong to Him. Amen. He's my sword. He's my shield. He's my buckler. He's my high tower. He's my helmet of salvation. He's my protection. Allow God to fight for you. Because greater is He that's within you than he that's in the world. Greater is He. You hear me? If God be for me, I don't care who's in here today, you can't be against me. Normal ordaining council has 3 members. I'm trying to quit. I really am. I just feel too good. July 31st, 1993. 100 and some degrees. And we sat in a van, had the air conditioning going on. When they set up the conference that morning, all the ordaining council wasn't there. My uncle come in late. Notice I said my uncle. Actually, my great uncle. And they put somebody else in his place. Because you got to have 3. So when it came time to examine the old boy, they took me out in this van. And he went with them. And they began to ask me question after question after question as far as concerning doctrine of the Bible. Little Walls looked to me. He said, Jamie, he said, what are you going to do if we turn you down today and don't ordain you? And I said, Lord, the only thing I know to do is preach. Because God called me and God ordained me. I said, if you fellas don't, I said, I'll do my best and make whatever requirements that you need me to come back if you don't approve me today. And I said, once you know, I'm going to keep going on. I ain't quitting. Can I tell you there ain't no quitting me right now, 25 years later? Amen. Amen. I really wanted to sing that song this morning more than anything. I just, with the way my sinuses are draining, I thought, nope. But I cannot tell you today, more than fame, wealth, or desire, more than all this world's attire, but Johnny, I've got one goal. Enter in, my child. I got to make it. I'm telling you today, God will do the same thing for you. I want these girls to come right now and get a song. I want you to sing just as I am. Because you see, because that's the only way you can come to God is just as you are. And if your life is not full, if there's something lacking in your life, maybe the fire that was there now is just a flickering ember ready to go out. And you need rekindle. That's what revival's all about today. That David prayed, God, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. I want you to come just as you are and kneel at this altar and say, oh Lord, I need you. I need thee every hour. I need thee. That's the second song. Just sing, just as I am one time. Second song is going to be, I need thee, oh I need thee, as we stand.